Dear students, I will continue my discussions on Maxwell's equations. We'll discuss some of the fundamentals of vector calculus. I'll start with the line integral. So let's consider a length L from P to Q in the vector field A. So this is a vector field of A, and this length is consisting of small elemental length dl. So let's consider one such point, say M, around which a small elemental length dl, and draw a tangent to that point M, and let theta be the angle between the tangent and the vector field A. Then we can write the vector dot product of vector A dl is equal to A dl sine cos theta. A dl cos theta. So this product, we can integrate this along a line. So we can take the line integral of this product from P to Q. So line integral is given by P to Q ADL. If this path is a closed path, then the same integration over a closed path L is given by, so this is known as the line integral. So integration along a line. Now let us discuss surface integral. Now imagine a surface in a vector field of A. So this is the vector field of A, and this is the surface S. This surface is made up of small elemental surface ds, and consider one point M around which there is a small elemental surface ds, and in the vector field ds is written as ds, vector ds is equal to ds into a unit vector which is normal to the surface. Now if I take the product of the vector A and ds, this gives the flux of the vector field A through ds, and if I integrate this along the surface, over the surface, then it becomes a surface integral, and here this is integrated over the surface S, and this gives the flux of the vector field A through the entire surface S. So if the surface is a closed surface, then the symbol is like this. It's over a closed surface S. So this is about surface integral. Now let us discuss what is volume integral. So consider volume integral. Consider the charges in a space. Okay, let that be a point, say M, and surrounding that point, let's consider a elemental volume dV. Elemental volume dV, and let rho be the charge density. Charge density of the charges means charge per unit volume. And what is the charge present within this small elemental volume dV is given by rho dV. Now what is the total charges, the total charges present in a volume, in a given volume? Then we need to integrate this over the volume. So it is a volume integral dV. It gives the total charge present over the volume V. So this is about the volume integral. So I'll continue my talk in the next video.